Welcome everyone, I'm Ricky from TechTalk, and in today's video I'm going to go through the accessibility settings and options we find on the brand new Huawei P40 Pro Plus. So when you first get your device, there were some options at the beginning setup stage. So there were options for magnify and screen reader, as well as changing the text. So if you go and watch my unboxing video and setup video, it will show you them settings in there. But today we're going to go through the features and options you can change once your device is set up. So first of all is your volume key. So I'm just going to make sure the volume is turned up here. So there is something called a volume key shortcut. So you can press and hold the two volume keys together.
Screen reader. When touch exploration is enabled, you can touch the screen to learn what is under your finger. For example, there are icons on the current screen. Touch the screen and slide your finger to select an app. Home button. Huawei Home. Pull down to refresh.
So it's on our home page here, and I can touch different applications to know what they are.
App gallery. Themes. Music. Video. Support. Health. Double touch to activate. Double touch and hold to reveal more options.
So that lets us know what it is and what we can do with extra options. I can also highlight the time.
10:51. Double touch to activate.
I can also highlight the temperature.
10:51 Friday, the 9th of October, Prince's Risboro, sunny, current temperature 11 degrees Celsius, today's high 13 degrees, today's low 5 degrees.
So it goes through everything for me, which is really great to see. And this works throughout the system wide, wherever you are, whatever application you're in, it will narrate everything back to you. You've got gesture controls to move around.
Screen 2 of 2. Screen 1 of 2.
If we go into settings.
Settings, sir.
And then two fingers. You get tone of going up and down.
Home button. Huawei Home. Pull down to refresh.
It's not saying Huawei quite correctly there, but it's narrating everything for us. You can also go up to your system items up here at the top, and we can highlight as well.
Battery 19%. NFC enabled. 10:52.
So that is the voiceover reading service, which is really good to see here and really nice to see that they've implemented this on the Huawei device, and I'm really impressed to see what else they have. So let's turn this off.
Screen reader disabled.
So now let's go and have a look at further accessibility settings. So go into your settings icon, scroll all the way down to the bottom, which I've already done here. And what you need to do is accessibility features. So inside here, we've got accessibility. So at the very top is accessibility. So at the very top, we've got screen reader, which I've just shown you, which is preset to the volume key shortcut. You can go in here and you can change settings if you want to, but a great option to see. We then have text to speech, which can change your pitch. And for some reason, it's grayed out on the speech rate here, but it's using Huawei's text to speech option. So it's nice to still have that option inside here. You have mono audio, so you can choose if you want mono audio. We then have captions, and you can turn captions on or off. So if we toggle them on here, you've got a couple of presets. So we've got language, we've got text size and caption style that you can change and adjust. And it's nice to see that we have captions on here. Underneath that, you have color correction, and you can toggle color correction on here, and you can choose which one you want. And again, you have a couple of presets here to choose from. And again, you can toggle that on or off, just depending on you. Underneath that, we've got magnification. So I'm going to toggle on. So once toggled on, one, two, three quick taps, and your whole display will zoom in, and you can see everything on your display here, which is really good wherever you go. So I can go right at the top here. I can see bits there. I can also pinch in as well. And as you've got a really large, beautiful display here, you can really see everything in great detail. So come back, one, two, three to come back. There is also another option, one, two, three. Hold on your third tap, and then it'll quickly zoom in, but as soon as you let go, it'll zoom out, which is a really good option. So wherever you are, so we're in our settings here, three quick taps, and again, you'll be able to magnify. So one, two, three, we can magnify and see our options here. One, two, three, to come back again. Great option to see magnification on here as well. You then have a large mouse pointer. So if you want to use a mouse pointer to navigate around your device, you can do. Underneath that, you've got color inversion. So once this is toggled on, it'll come out of dark mode and it'll invert the colors. So if I go back home here, you'll notice the colors are inverted. So a bit different when you're in dark or light mode, but the colors are inverted and it makes it a little bit easier for someone to see. So let's just jump back down into accessible settings here and into accessibility, and we can turn this off and it should naturally go back into dark mode, which it does, which is a really good option. You have high contrast text, and this is going to be making it easier to read the subtitles and text for you if you want to. And it's taken us out of dark mode, but I'll show you how to get back into that. Underneath that, we've got advanced visual effects, so you can turn these on or off depending on your choice. Underneath that is the accessibility shortcut, and that was where I was pressing the two volume keys. So you've got shortcuts, and you can also do it on the lock screen, and you can choose which option you want to change. So if you don't want it to narrate to you, you can actually choose a different option. Really good options to see here. Underneath that, you've got touch and hold delay. So this is for dexterity and interaction. You've got click after cursor stops. So if you're using a large mouse or pointer, it'll click after you've stopped moving. The power button can end calls. So the power button is down the right-hand side here, and it's just underneath the volume controls. Sadly, there's no visual or tactile differences between the options there. But again, it's nice to have these options built into the accessibility settings. Finally, at the bottom, we've got about answering calls with Bluetooth device and member center, where you can go and get some help or advice. Or if you do need any help or advice, please leave a comment below and I'm gonna be more than happy to help. So that's all the options that we find in accessibility section. So going back to the main accessibility features section here, that was really nice to see all the options that Huawei have implemented in accessibility options. As they have lost Google services now, they had to create their own, and they've done a really good job here, and it makes the device accessible, and that's really important for myself with a visual impairment, and also really important to anyone else that may need to change their device settings to allow them to use this great smartphone. So underneath, they've got some other options that might be beneficial to you. So you've got one hand mode. So if you're using the three capacitive touch buttons, you'd go from the middle to the left or the right. If you're using the gesture control that we're using here, you're gonna swipe up from the bottom corners in a diagonal motion. And you can toggle that on and use that if you want to. A good option if your hand can't reach right across the display. Then we've got shortcuts and gestures. And inside here, we've got a lot of different options. So your first one is AI voice. And you have an AI system built in here that can help you do different things with your phone and also find you different options from the web as well. So toggle that on and use that. And that uses the power button. You then have an ultra snapshot. This is where you can use the button to take a quick snapshot or open the camera to capture that perfect moment. So taking a screenshot, you just knock on the display. So there we go, it's taking a screenshot for me, which is great, and I can use that later. Or I could even share that over to the actual Huawei Matebook if I want to with Huawei Share. You can also draw a zero. And that's highlighted that little section for me. And now I can highlight that and send that off to a friend or family, which is another good option. And then finally, you've got scroll shots. So if you draw an S, and we're gonna allow, and that'll start to scroll for me, which is a really good option if there's a web page that you want to share to someone as well. Really good options to have here, and new gesture control options, which I really like. You have the option to record your screen. That uses two knuckles, so simply just tap on with two knuckles, and then this will allow you to start recording your screen if you so want to. We've got wake screen. So this is where you lift it up and it wakes up. So if we lock it here, lift up, and as you can see, it uses a face unlock, and away we go again. Underneath that, we've got mute ringtone and notifications. So you flip over and this will silence it for you. And also you've got the other option of where you'll pick it up and you'll see your notifications coming in, which again, a good option to see there. Answering calls. So you can actually lift up your device to answer a call if you so want to. Don't want that one just in case I don't want to answer the call. And then you have air gesture. So you've got to air scroll. So you just swipe down, you then have air scroll to swipe up, you just flick up, and you can actually grab a screenshot. So let's try it out. So we're gonna go yes, and we're gonna start. There we go. And we can grab shot as well, and we're gonna try this. So all it is a clamp of the hand. There we go, it's grabbed a shot for us. Great little options there to use. So you might not use them all the time, but it's nice to have these options available to you. So that's what's in gesture and shortcuts. Then you have multi-window. So you have a multi-window option here if you so want to use it. You've got the peak option where you can pull out here and you can choose the application. Tap again. And then you just drag an application. We can get another application. So say this one. And we're going to split it in half. So you can watch content or you can browse your files and you can do multiple different things all in one go. And we can swipe up to go home and it instantly go home. And then if you swipe up here, you've got our multi-window still open, which is really good that you can just jump straight back into. So I like using the multi-window option there to view content while I'm maybe browsing the web as well. Really good options to see there. We have smart cover. So if you have the Huawei smart cover for the Huawei P40 Pro Plus, you can use the smart cover. Just toggle that switch on. Underneath, we have mistouch prevention. So if you accidentally double tap, don't worry. This option toggled on will save you. We have glove mode. It's getting very cold here in the UK, very autumnal now. Lovely, beautiful colors. And I can't wait to actually take some shots on this phone. But glove mode will mean that you can use that if you want to. And then finally at the bottom, we've got system navigation. So for some of the settings, you're going to need the three keys at the bottom, or you can use gesture, or they've got one other mode here, which has a dock. And you can use a main dock if you want to. I prefer gesture because then I've got all of my display. So that's everything that you see in the accessibility features section there in settings. Just the other one I want to highlight is your display. So display and brightness, you can change the brightness, so quite low at the moment, but it is a very bright display. Really nice to see. You can have it automatic, which will then change and adjust depending on your light source around you. Underneath that, you've got color mode and temperature. So you can change and adjust the colors depending on you. Underneath that is sleep. So this is when it automatically goes to sleep. I've got it on the longest. Eye comfort, it's got a Tuvaland certification for eye comfort control. Really good options on here, and you can filter the blue mode. You also have flicker reduction here at the bottom, a good option to see there. So just go through, change the settings depending on you. Dark mode, let's toggle this back on. We'll go into dark mode for you. And for me, what I really do like to see here, and this changes wherever you go in the system. So if I just toggle this off again, pull down, you'll notice it changes instantly wherever you go. Some applications, yes, will work. Some maybe not. Text and display size. This should always be an accessibility, but they leave it in display for some reason. So you can change your text size and your display size, and you've got some presets here, and you can change and adjust them. Really good options to see there. Obviously a very beautiful display, and you can change the screen resolution depending on you. Currently got it smart, but you can set it to high or low, and it just depends what you want to do, really. If you want your battery to last all day, maybe a little bit lower, or smart option, but it just depends what you want. You've got screen refresh rate, so I've got it set to high, and you can have it set to standard. It just means when you flick through a menu, it'll go smooth like butter. You've got more display settings, but nothing really there important to use. The only other one that I do want to mention here is simple mode. And this just makes it a little bit easier for you. Larger icons, strips away a lot of the actual overlay stuff, just makes it easier to use. So there are the settings there that are important when it comes to accessibility. So as well as all the settings and the features that I've just shown, you can also use this application here that I launched with Honor, and it's through the Huawei App Gallery. It's called Pocket Vision. It's a great application. I'm really pleased to say that I still use this now for different things around me. You can take a screenshot of something and it will use the AI system on board to read it back to you. I'll put the link into my TV campaign and also a full review of this application, but it's really nice to see you can download this on a Huawei device as well. So swiping up and going back home, it's really nice to see all the options and settings that Huawei have implemented for accessibility on their new device. And it's really important that, yes, they've stepped away from Google and the services that they offer, but that meant also that Google removed some of the accessibility settings, which was a little bit worrying. Not to worry though, Huawei have implemented their own, created their own options, and it's just as good to use as what previous devices were. Really happy to see the options on here, making it accessible for me to use as a visually impaired person, and hopefully making it accessible for you to use as well, no matter your ability. To you, the audience, what do you think? Is it accessible enough? Could they do more? Could you see something different on here? Let me know in the comments. It's always great to hear from you. For me, Ricky, thank you always for watching. If you haven't yet, please subscribe to stay updated with all of my latest videos. Stay safe, stay well, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.